The natural world contains an incredible amount of biodiversity. It is thus difficult to fathom how the innumerable life forms on Earth have evolved from a single universal ancestor. Charles Darwin suggested that the environment selects for individuals with advantageous traits, giving them a higher chance of reproductive success. Natural selection is thus an intrinsic process in the evolution of species. However, some scientists in the early 20th century held on to Lamarckian beliefs that the environment drives heritable genetic change. This included Frederick Clements, a colleague of Hall, the man who pioneered the transplant experiments that we will examine today. Contrary to Hall's beliefs, Clements claimed that lowland plants would transform into alpines when transplanted into the alpine environment. Thus, the experimental studies on the nature of species, a series of four monumental works in biological literature, was created to elucidate the process of speciation in natural environments. Plant biologists previously observed that populations of plants differing in numerous traits occupied climatically distinct regions. These populations were termed ecotypes by the Swedish biologist Turesson. Separate species, or ecospecies, consisted of groups of ecotypes sharing characteristic traits. Species complexes, or cenospecies, consisted of groups of ecospecies that were reproductively incompatible. Clausen, Keck, and Heisey's first publication, Effect of Varied Environments on Western North American Plants, aimed to determine the effect of the environment on the morphology and physiology of ecotypes. This was achieved by performing reciprocal transplants between three experimental stations with highly variable climates along a transect across California. Stanford, the coastal station, had a warm, temperate climate. Mather, the mid-altitude station, experienced moderate temperatures, while Timberline, situated at the apex of the Sierra Nevada, experienced freezing temperatures during winter. Genetically identical cuttings of individuals from a range of ecotypes across the transect were transplanted into each of these gardens. The researchers reasoned that variation between plants in the same garden has a genetic basis, while variation between genetically identical individuals across gardens is due to environmental adaptation. Modifications or changes in morphology or physiological processes such as growth rate, size, and periods of dormancy were measured. Clausen's team observed that individuals retained their defining characteristics such as flower color and leaf shape throughout transplantation. Once transplanted individuals were returned to their native environment, their original traits were restored, suggesting that modifications are reversible. Ecotypes derived from regions of similar climate were observed to react similarly when transplanted to the same garden, whereas ecotypes from dissimilar climatic regions would display different reactions. Two different plants also showed no tendency to become identical when transplanted into the same garden, refuting Clement's proposition. By crossing different ecotypes and examining the segregation of traits, Clausen's team verified that most observed traits had a genetic basis. Furthermore, their observations of ecotype distribution suggested that ploidy number did not dictate an ecotype's adaptability to extreme environments, contradicting popular claims in literature. They proposed that an organism's ability to adapt was due to its gene expression, which overshadows any potential effects of chromosome number. Clausen's team concluded that a plant must be in equilibrium with its environment for it to succeed. The plant's gene activity regulates the balance of proteins produced, which impacts its morphology and rate of physiological processes. If these processes occur at the ideal rate for survival in a particular environment, the plant will be successful. Otherwise, it is likely to be eliminated by natural selection. From these experiments, Clausen's team proposed that speciation occurs gradually and in stages. It is mediated by genetic changes such as mutation or polyploidy that disrupt the equilibrium between the plant and its native environment. As a result, its gene activity now regulates a different physiological rhythm that may form a stable equilibrium with a new environment. These locally adapted races are ecotypes. Climatic differences between regions provide a weak barrier that discourages gene exchange between ecotypes. Over time, reproductively isolated ecotypes may give rise to differentiated species, given that the precise equilibrium requirements are satisfied. The results of Clausen, Keck, and Heisey studies have been invaluable to the field of evolutionary biology. Their ingenious experimental design and copious amounts of empirical data provided strong evidence for the process of speciation, highlighting the fundamental role of the environment in preserving and increasing biodiversity. These findings thus enhance our understanding of evolution and the origin of the extraordinary variability we see today.